So how do you take your initial brilliant ideas for science videos and actually get them made and then onto YouTube? Well, I'm going to walk you through the 10-step process that I've been using for several years, and which I like to think about kind of like climbing a mountain, where each segment in this path represents one of those 10 steps. Some of the segments are longer and steeper, some of them are easier, but they're all necessary to get my videos all the way to YouTube. So the first step involves capturing the verbal and the visual ideas or ingredients that I might use in my video. Now, as I capture these, I put these in a place where I can find them later when I need them. The verbal ideas might just be a list of words or concepts that I want to include, whereas the visual ideas could be a whole bunch of different things. Now, the first step is pretty relaxed and it's pretty easy, but it can be extended over several days to weeks to years. Kind of depends on the complexity of the video and when I want to get it done by. Okay, so as you can see, this second step is pretty darn intense. And this involves writing the script for the narrative of my video. This forms the backbone or the main structure of the video. And I only start this step when I'm confident that I've got enough verbal and visual material to work with and a pretty good idea, you know, how it all fits together. As I write this, I read it out loud to see how it sounds and feels, and I time it to make sure it fits into the time frame I want for the video. I set that time frame right from the beginning to help me stay focused and only take the critical ideas forward on my journey up the steep cliff on this mountain. Now, I often find that using a speech-to-text app helps me to create the early drafts of my script in a much more natural way than if I was, you know, typing it out. As I refine the script, I often add notes in the margins about visuals that I might use at certain points. And I'll tell you, when I finish the narrative, I have a huge sense of relief and a boost in confidence when I look back down and realize how far I've come, that I'm making really good progress, and I'm actually finished with the most difficult part of my journey up the mountain. So step three involves recording the narrative. Now, for a video like this, where I'm on screen in front of the camera, I sit in front of the camera and I read my narrative from a teleprompter. But for a simpler video where I'm just doing a voiceover and I'm not on screen, I just read that narrative directly into my computer. When I record it, I try to sound enthusiastic and pretend like I'm talking to one of my good friends or family members. So step four begins the actual video editing process, and this is where I put that recorded narrative onto a track in my video editor program, and then I cut out the parts that I don't need, where I made mistakes or things like that. Okay, then I move on to step five. Now, this is a really fun step for me because this is where I'm able to take all those visuals and put those in with the narrative. And to help with this, I look back to the PowerPoint file where I've got all my visuals ideas stored. And I'll remember, oh yeah, hey, there's that cool photograph or illustration. Let me add that to this part of the narrative. Now, once I've added all the visuals and I'm happy with the flow of the video, it's looking pretty good, then I output it as an MP4 file. And I move on to step seven, which is where I show it to different people to get their feedback. For this, what I like to do is I like to actually watch them watch the video and I observe their reaction. Are they paying attention? Do they look bored? Are they laughing when it makes sense or not when I didn't think they should be laughing? And then after watching the video, do they ask me questions that tell me that they understood my message? Then I take that feedback and I make corrections or modifications where they make sense. And then I move on to the next step, which is where I create the accurate closed captions file so that the video will be accessible to people who are hard of hearing or deaf. And then I finally come around that last turn in my journey up the mountain where I'm ready to upload my video to YouTube. Now, as I do this, I make sure that I've got a good description for the video. I've got keywords so that it can easily be searched for. I've got a nice thumbnail that goes with it. And I'm ready to share my science with the world. So that's my process, the 10-step process. I hope that this helps you to take all your brilliant ideas for science videos and get them out to the world. I'll see you at the top of the mountain.